Hi guys, how's it going? Today I want to show you a project by Italian photographer Guido Guidi, recently published by MAC in a book simply titled In Veneto 1984-1989.
Mariano Sartore wrote, "The 1960s and 1970s represent a period of profound social and economic change for Italy as a whole, but even more for what could be defined as Terza Italia, Third Italy, the area comprising the northeast and parts of central Italy. Why third? Because the old distinction between the north with all its industrial development and the south, where a system based on the old agricultural system still persisted with increasing economic backwardness, was starting to be seen as an anomaly. The epicenter of this third Italy was Veneto, a region extending from the Alps to the Adriatic and including the vast Po Valley plain, the richest land in the country, a region with a dense urban grid made up of small and medium-sized towns and cities, none of which competed with the regional capital, Venice. It was also an area beset with poverty going back centuries, even during the decades following World War II. Mass tourism started to act as a guarantee for the development of the coastal zone, which previously had been areas of downright hardship. The tourism economy in the mountains was pickier, selecting only specific places to invest in and marginalizing the majority of the internal valleys, where the old trends of emigration and decline continued. This was a region split in two, where the urban was rich and the rural poor. The whole thing based on a reciprocal functional system designed to preserve the balance. Industrial development in Italy concentrated in the northwest, the Milan-Turin-Genoa triangle. The northeast was excluded, except for Porto Marghera in Veneto, a petrochemical hub which Count Giuseppe Volpi had sought in the 1920s. It represented a major opportunity, but its sole purpose was to reduce the huge flow of emigrants to other continents, richer parts of Europe, or the Industrial Triangle. Veneto continued to be seen as a poor agricultural region. The reasons why there was little or no development in such a fertile part of the country are complex, but studying the particular nature of the social relations underlying agricultural production reveals an important key to its understanding. The land ownership system showed the clear predominance of large holdings by aristocratic, city-based families who lived in Venice rather than in any other city. The management practices were also unlike anywhere else in Italy. There was no latifundium system, characteristic of the South, no large directly managed capitalist holdings, and little sharecropping. The predominant form involved leasing tiny parcels of the property to families who would then run them. Both systems were based on parceling out the land and protecting the farm, thus giving rise to a scattered level of settlement over virtually the entire rural Veneto region. This sort of isolated settlement was also based on the dense road network that still exists today, and the infrastructure for water supply that developed over the centuries from Roman centuriation to the huge improvement works carried out by the Republic of Venice. The conditions of farmers in Veneto, who would run a small leased farm handed down from one generation to the other, remain unchanged for centuries. Equally unchanged remained the correlation between family size and farm size. During fascism, national policies encouraged the transfer of land ownership to the tenants that had been cultivating it for generations. A credit system was also put in place to support farm mechanization. At the end of the 1960s, productivity of the soil no longer came from crops, but from the returns that the new owners could earn by converting the land into plots suitable for building. This was often a necessary process, taking place in roadside farm lots so that farmers could handle the debt they had incurred by purchasing the land and farm equipment. During the following years, agriculture was slowly marginalized in favor of peripheral development, also known as widespread industrialization or district development. The new model was based on the multi-phase division of the productive cycle, each being assigned to one of the many micro companies capable of performing the work. With little capital, small or very small companies could start up and take the place of big companies. They succeeded in specializing and improving the product or the manufacturing process, thus growing their competitiveness. At the same time, their small size guaranteed the necessary flexibility to reconvert if demand reduced or more profitable manufacturing processes appeared. This model is based on and reaches into the social relationships needed to ensure mutual trust between businesses in a system that is too complex to be regulated by formal contracts. It was essential to belong to a local system and to make products that supported activities the local area was specialized in. It was in this cultural framework that research into urban sprawl advanced in the early 1980s, in an attempt to help interpret a phenomenon that had been little investigated by urbanists, who concentrated on big cities and metropolis, but not small towns and even less rural areas. The research coordinated by Giorgio Piccinato at UAV sought to document the profound transformations taking place in the region as a result of residential and industrial sprawl. Attention was paid to the changing relation between buildings and roads, the novel forms of micro-concentration, and the new organization of residential micro-neighborhoods. The lack of government policies allowed companies and families to sort things out for themselves. Development in Veneto was based on laissez-faire. It was in this framework, when the research had entered its middle phase and the complexity of the phenomenon being studied was clearer, that Guido Guidi was involved in the project. This research allowed Guidi to devote himself on a more continuous basis to observing certain marginal and interstitial areas that were typical of the Veneto sprawl.
The volume contains a selection of 44 previously unpublished photographs taken with a Dierdorf 8x10 camera and two essays by Stefania Russell and Mariano Sartore, and was published on the occasion of an exhibition at Museo Casa Giorgione in Castelfranco Veneto, Italy. Ask for the book at your local bookstore. Thank you very much for watching this video and see you in the next one.